You hear me? Oh, yes, right now. Hi, everyone. Welcome, everyone, to this beautiful house of God, house of worship. Welcome, online brothers and sisters. Today, we will celebrate the communion and the love of God shared through the Son, Jesus Christ. So prepare an appropriate material, so juice and bread. I'm Pastor Hae-jung. If you are new here, I'm going to extend a specially warm welcome to you. Today is also World Communion Sunday. So all the world, today we celebrate as World Communion on Sunday. So special envelopes are included in your bulletin. Your generosity will change, transform, and the precious people's lives. Now let's greet the person next to you and front and back by saying, "Peace of God be always with you. Peace of God will be always with you." Okay, say to them.
Good morning.
Morning.
Today's announcements are in your bulletin. Your bulletin today is given by Tom Latham in celebration of his birthday. Happy birthday, Tom.
Hey, happy birthday.
As the pastor mentioned, today is World Communion Sunday. This is an opportunity to help promising young adults to become leaders. If you would like to invite Pastor Hae-jung to your home for a blessing of your home and family, please contact Amy in the church office. Today at 11 o'clock in the lounge is the Identity Theft Question and Answer Session with Sergeant Bobby Schatzko from the West Bend Police Department. All are welcome. Pastor Hae-jung is having the prayer meeting today at 4 p.m. in the sanctuary. Please consider attending and experience God's miraculous power in our daily lives. Ann Cording's Celebration of Life is Saturday, October 26th. Visitation is at 10 o'clock. A luncheon will take place after the service in Fellowship Hall. Dinner church training is scheduled for Sundays, October 27th and November 17th, and lunch will be provided. A flyer is in your bulletin. The Cedar Community Chimes and Fifth Avenue Bells concert is Sunday, October 27th at 2 p.m. in the sanctuary. Pastor Hae-jung will be preparing fresh Korean food on Sunday, November 3rd at 4 o'clock at the Parsonage. The time and location has changed to allow preparation of fresh food and to create a warm environment. Please RSVP to Amy by Monday, October 28th. The ALB meeting is Sunday, November 10th in the Fireside Room. Our church conference Sunday is on Sunday, November 10th, also at 2 p.m. All are welcome. This completes today's announcements, and now at this time, I would like to invite Ellen Johnson to come forward.
Today being a very special day for the whole world, It's also honoring your pastor day. It's not on my calendar either. And would you come over here, please? Okay. On behalf of your leadership, people, and the whole congregation, we want to just a little something and to let you know how much we appreciate you and your music and your kind prayers and thoughts. So welcome to our family.
Thank you so much. Thank
you're you. Welcome.
So no children message? Okay. All right, let's pass. Close our eyes, take a deep breath. Enter your deepest soul, where God's shrine is. Holy God of unconditional love and unlimited presence, we come to make ourselves fully available to you, your will, your way. Speak to us gently and clearly, for we are yours and desire to hear, understand, and be obedient to your word. Speak, for we are listening. Amen. The first song will be Black Hymnal 2108. Please stand up if you will.
Love for sinners to show what he did there brought hope from despair. Oh, how he loves you! Oh, how he loves me! Oh, how he loves you and me!
Join me in the call to worship. If you are tired, come and worship.
If you're hungry, come and worship.
If you are filled with joy, come and worship.
If your spirit feels renewed, come and worship.
Our Our God desires our worship, whether we have much or little to give.
There is healing when we come before our God.
All who are gathered here, come and worship. And please pray with me. God of life, there are days when the burdens we carry chafe our shoulders and wear us down, when the road seems dreary and endless, the skies gray and threatening, when our lives have no music in them, and our hearts are lonely, and our souls have lost their courage. Flood the path with light, we beseech thee. Turn our eyes to where the skies are full of promise. Guide us as we worship, that all we sing and speak and pray will honor your great name. Amen.
If able, please stand up. Let's sing the song of the doxology.
Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures hear me. Praise Him above ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Please join me in the offertory prayer. O God, receive these gifts given in your Son's name as we seek to walk in your ways. Use them to bring the healing, kindness, and justice of Christ's humble love to all those in need.
Let's share our joys and concerns. Is there any joys or concerns that you want to share with us? Please receive the microphone.
Hello from the balcony.
Yes.
Richard Sussman asked that I please pass along his prayer concerns for his parents. For the life of me, I don't remember what his parents' first names are. His dad was taken to the emergency room last night, and his mother has been in assisted living for at least the last 3 weeks. As Richard Slay and I were driving to the church, we passed Richard Sussman on his way to visit his dad, first at the hospital, then his mother at the assisted living.
Thank you, Mike. Merciful God, hear our prayers.
Please remember all of those that are fighting with damage to their houses, their cities, their roads from the storms down in Florida and into southern central Wisconsin or United States. I've seen pictures on television, and it's just incredible. They have lost absolutely everything. So prayer for strength for those people. Amen.
Merciful God, hear our prayers.
I would say that we need to celebrate. Celebrate the fall, the colors. They are just gorgeous. Yeah. If you haven't gotten out, it's time to go for a ride.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Loving God, we give you thanks. Amen.
And I am looking forward to a nice fall day, being out and about with my family. My two sisters are coming, and we will celebrate all three of our birthdays. And then this evening, we are going with our grandson and daughter to the zoo for Boo Zoo Day.
Loving God, we give you thanks.
Like to have prayers said for the families that lost their homes this weekend over on Creek Drive. It was close to home because my granddaughter lived there just 2 years ago, and the building was now destroyed and uninhabitable.
Merciful God, hear our prayers. Let's pray. As we enter into this time of prayers, O God, we offer at first our gratitude that you are always present with us. Instill in us a desire, so listen to others, listen to the pain of others. Through all the hurricanes, storms, help us to listen to them with open hearts and open minds, that others might feel safe and protected in our presence, in their presence too. Instill in us a spirit of serenity, that others might feel accepted in your non-judgmental grace. Free us from the tendency to label people and ideas, and allow us instead to lean into mercy and kindness. In the stillness of this moment, we acknowledge the times when we have been less than kind, merciful, and open. Thank you for never banning us from your presence, loving God. Hear our prayers that were lifted up to you. Send us your mercy, your healing, your protection, your hope, joy, and peace. We pray this in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Scripture reading today is from Romans 12, verses 11 through 14, and Galatians chapter 6, not 5 as printed, verses 22 to 23. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spirit fervor, serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with the Lord's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you, and bless and do not curse. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. Let's pray. Let the word of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord. Amen. God created us in his image, right? We enjoy that kind of such a privilege that we are created. One of the beauties of being human is the ability to express our hearts, our emotion. But how does God walk with us when negative emotion threatens to overwhelm and take in charge? How does God do this? How are emotions being shaped to reflect his image? And what does that process look like? The goal is not to eliminate emotions from our spiritual growth. Instead, it is to discover the emotions that God wants us to experience. Take an example of God's unchanging love and perfect love. God is full of emotion. God created emotion that we have. Then the origin of God's heart that created emotion, how much, how full is God's emotion is there, occurs. Wonderful emotion God has. It cannot be simply explained. We can imagine if we love somebody, it is difficult to stay calm. We want to express, we hug and we smile and we want to say something. I love you so much. That is, I thought like this. Yes, we want to share. And we smile, we hug. God is God of joy. And joy is also a very deep emotion. And God's joy amazingly overflows. You might not imagine how it is like. In the Bible, it is written, I've written your name on my palm every day. Whenever I move around, I see your name, and I made a song for you uniquely, and I sing the song in my heart with joy. Is it like your feeling about God? God is joyful towards me and with me. It's really to me, it is really to you. So if you think like that, you need to drink God's joy into your heart more and more so that it becomes yours. Every word he speaks to us produces joy in our hearts. John 15:11 says, I have told you this so that my joy may be in you. My joy may be in you, and your joy may be complete. God's word. And joy and peace always go together. Joy is like this, so calm joy and beautiful joy and upon the peace. It is layered together. Joy and peace always go together. Peace of God is definitely an emotion, the place of calm and undisturbed rest. Peace empowers the capacity to experience stillness. His peace goes deep enough to the root of negative emotions and pulls them out by the root and brings your heart to the place of calm rest. Now, this sounds good. I love that. To calm the storm, peace is essential. The Prince of peace, Jesus, the Prince of Peace, can do all of that in you and through you. Our process of spiritual maturity isn't just about upgrading our mindset or perception. It includes encountering God's emotion so that we may be transformed by what we encountered in Him. When we look at the fruit of the Holy Spirit, it's about the portrait of who God is: love, joy, peace, and continuously, etc., etc., etc. God's emotion toward us is like so. And we respond to God's emotion too. When we hear the love of Jesus, our hearts feel cherished by the beloved as the beloved and loved with an everlasting love, which is hesed love. When our hearts are broken, we are filled with complex emotions such as deep, overwhelming despair, sadness, emotional turmoil, often accompanied with a feeling of worthlessness or sometimes hopelessness. However, when we experience the profound love of God that melts our hearts are healed. God's voice is so gentle, so melting your heart. We are healed when we hear the voice of God, the word of God, deeply. When we experience His compassion after our hearts are being broken, your hearts are healed, restored. When I began a ministry in a remote place of California, north part of California, next to Nevada, it was high desert area, and there was a big prison complex. At that time, I was overseeing two small churches. One church was located by the beautiful lake area. Another church, it was Susanville Church, mainly known as a prison complex. Lake Church, Chester Church, Susanville Church. And Chester Church was mainly from city dwellers. So they came from the city to stay there during a certain season, and after retirement, they wanted to stay there. So beautiful. And with them, I had great joy, and so we respect each other, and they highly respected me as pastor. And on the other hand, in Susanville Church, it was a really remote place. There was no coming and going. People lived there for a long time. Never seen an Asian woman with accent as a leadership. So they saw me, of course. Yeah, there are certain kinds of racial prejudice. I understand that because of their living condition like that. But my understanding didn't save me from pain. So I didn't want to be their pastor, but I had to endure because God called me. I had no other choice. I had pain. It was like my feeling at that time regarding the Susanville Church. It's like a cold, rainy days of heart. On the other hand, Chester Church was summer, beautiful vacation day. Enjoyed a lot, painful a lot. So there was good balance, right? One day, I came from the church at home, and I simply kneeled before God and didn't say anything at all. God knew already what's going on, and God visited me for a short moment. Very, very powerful way. Never before I experienced that beautiful presence. Just came to me, touched my heart, a couple of seconds. It's not a long time, but it was so incredibly beautiful love towards me, filled with beauty, holiness, joy, all the bliss of heaven. It was, I wanted to stay there forever. I love that. Such a beautiful moment. And disappeared. When it disappeared, my heart was aching. Oh, where do you go, Lord? So I wanted to have that moment again and again and prayed, Lord, show me once again that much. Of course, God is always with us, but the intensity of that moment was 30%, 40%, 50%, unbelievably intense, beautiful. So I thought everybody should know this God. Everybody should experience this beauty. Everybody should experience this love. I wanted to really send God's love to people even more than before. After the brief visitation of God's presence, the situation didn't change anything at all, but I was changed because I was touched and healed. I was touched by the love. The presence melt my heart and in some way healed, not fully. Pain was always ongoing there, but healed. I felt that. And there was healing of heart and pain was present still. I knew God's love is far, far greater, deeper, bigger than whatever you go through in your life situation. We stay sometimes in that kind of situation, in tumultuous pain, and coming out of that, and sometimes of peace we enjoy, and going into that situation again. Life is the whole, that process, up and down. And so, but wherever you are, God's love is far deeper than your negative, painful emotion, and go deeper than that, root out the negative emotion with the power of love. Recently, I received a song from God with the lyrics as follows. If you read the e-newsletter, you might have read this lyric. I loved you before time began. I've held you close even when you were a child. I've always been with you. I've not left you. I will never leave you. We'll get through this together. We will get through this together. We will get through this together. You are not alone. Rest now in my arms of love. Rest now in my arms of love. Did you hear this song? I put into the so devotion. And so if you didn't, hear, then text me. I will send you again. God understands your emotion because he created you with them. So in your difficulty, he is not afraid of your feeling. The antidote to the negative feeling is not to vanish emotion from our spiritual development. It is to discover the emotion of God that he wants us to experience and give us instead. For every negative emotion we have, there is a living, powerful emotion in his heart that he wants to share. He will pour himself upon you until you become so captivated by the beauty of it that you lose any attachment to the negativity. You experience sadness, frustration, worry, hostility, victim thinking, and so on. It is all about practicing new inner man, your new man, inner man in Jesus Christ. Your inner man is mingled, united with the Holy Spirit. You need to be in your inner man, inner self, inner woman, inner self, inner self. Our new nature is being with one with the Holy Spirit. As we behold God's true nature, we simply become more like Him when we behold, look at God's true nature. This is this power becoming like God from the process of focus. Focus is such an important word in a spiritual world. You might say, well, I still, even though you say such a wonderful things, da-da-da-da, from now, I feel negativity in my heart. I cannot ignore that at all. How can I simply focus? Yes, right. But listen to the word of God. It is Romans chapter 6, verse 12. You should consider. The reality is there, but you should consider your old man with negativity is dead and gone. Because Jesus has paid a high price. So our pain and such negative emotions belong to Jesus. It's not mine. Jesus paid that. It's Jesus. We should instead enjoy the new nature. Consider, God knows, I know you have feel that kind of feeling. I know you have that, but consider that it's dead and no more there. Can you practice this? Yes. That is, we should practice when negative emotion overwhelms, simply ignore, because there is no focus on negative emotion, right? It doesn't hurt you anymore, cannot hurt you anymore. Focus gives you power upon which you choose to focus. The power of focus in our mental flow process is like that. Focus, let the things you focus on be powerful. When we focus on Jesus, Jesus' power, God's power increases. This idea shows a way how to become a new person. So, main tool is focusing on God so that God's power increases in you. Focusing on God. So, it is good that we know the way, right? Focus is the, focal word. So, what are then some practical suggestions for this to focus? How can we make this focus happen more concretely? It's by focusing on our new nature in God. We are sons of God, daughters of God. Think about the nature, character of sons and daughters of God. The standard is so very high, we focus on that, okay? By focusing on the Word of God, it's reading the Bible, right? In the morning, in the evening. When you read the Bible, you open the Bible, right? And when you finish, you close the Bible. Do you close the Bible? Just let it open, okay? When you simply come by, you read one more verse, two more verse, hold it in your heart. And then come back again, continuously read and read. In the morning, full portion. In the evening, some less portion. But this way, let the word continuously flow in your life. Another way is turn your soul toward God as many times as possible. Through short prayers, we learn about the Jesus' prayer. Yes, Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on us. All human beings need mercy of God. So you have some more room to connect to God repeatedly, 100 times, 2,000, 4,000. Okay. I have an idea. If you continuously pray 2,000 times for 1 week, come to me. I'll give you a gift. Some motivation, beautiful gift, I will give it to you, okay? So it'll be wonderful. Increase the presence of God inside of you by continuously focusing on Him. It is the practice of monks and nuns in monastery throughout the whole history, through the whole world. When you focus, then inner self is alive, and inner self can have more understanding, because Holy Spirit is powerfully flowing in you, through you. It develops a new understanding of God, new nature of God, and also new mindset in you, and also emotions from Him. God will pour Himself out on you until you become so captivated by the beauty of God that you lose any attachment to cynicism, frustration, fear, hostility, all the negativities. So the first part of this transformation is releasing the attachment to the negativity by focusing on the beauty of God. Have our negative feelings turned into joy and peace? Not yet. Why do you hold on to negativity? Yeah? Seems like it is kind of habit, right? Habit or familiarity or kind of some comfort it can give. If this resonates with you, it's time for a fresh beginning, a fresh start toward embracing positivity flowing from God through you. Emotions are like filters. When our feelings are in line with God, our sensitivity to God's ways truly increases. And once you encounter God's kindness, love, and peace, joy, then you are able to practice staying there, not coming back down, staying there. Then the next stage of life comes. How do we stay there? Proverbs 18:10 states, "The name of the Lord is a strong tower. Righteous run in and are safe." No more coming down. Safe there. And the Passion Translation says, "The character of God is a tower of strength. For the lovers of God delight to run into His heart and be exalted on high." May this blessing be yours now and forever. God bless you. Take out your Holy Communion sheet.
Together on our knees. Let us praise God together on our knees. Let us praise God together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun,
Communion, we celebrate the love of God through Jesus Christ. UMC communion table is an open table. Whoever loves God and confess Jesus as Lord and Savior are welcome to this table. Christ our Lord invites us to his table, all who love him, who honestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. For a short moment, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your law. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you. We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and light, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
On the night when Jesus gave himself up for us, he took the bread, gave thanks to God, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Eat, take, this bread, this is my body broken for you. After the supper, the same way, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks to God, gave it to his disciples, saying, drink from this, all of you. This is my body shed for you for the forgiveness of sins, for the eternal covenant. And so in remembrance of these mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in present thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
Pour out all your Holy Spirit upon us gathered here, and upon these elements, gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. We may be, so that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen. 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 Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Ushers, could you please come forward? The table is ready. The table of grace and love and peace is ready. Come forward and receive the elements of God. Katie, what if Christ broke for you? Sherry, what if Christ broke for you? Brother, what if Christ broke for you? Thank you. take out communion sheet again at the last part. There is a prayer to pray together. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The closing hymn.
I come with joy to meet my Lord, forgiven, loved, and free. In awe and wonder to recall His life laid down for me. His life laid down for me. I come with Christians far and near to find, as all are fed, the new community of love in Christ's communion bread. In Christ's communion bread, as Christ breaks bread and bids us share, each proud division ends. The love that made us makes us one, and strangers now are friends. And strangers now are friends. And thus with joy we meet our Lord, His presence always near. Is in such friendship better known, we see and praise Him here. We see and praise Him here. Together meet, together bound, we go our different ways. And in His people in the world, we live and speak His praise. We live and speak His praise.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all now and forever. Amen.